1976 critically acclaimed made-for-TV movie Sybil tells the story of one of America's most famous psychiatric patients, a woman named Sybil Dorset exhibiting dissociative identity disorder. After an episode in front of her students, Sybil goes to see psychiatrist Dr. Cornelia Wilbur, who after years of treatment helps Sybil to make peace with her trauma and live a fulfilling life despite her disorder. Dissociative identity disorder, also referred to as DID or multiple personality disorder, is characterized primarily by two or more distinct personalities residing in the same individual. According to the DSM-5, each of these personalities have their own relatively enduring pattern of perceiving, relating to, and thinking about the environment and self.
Sybil? I hate Sybil. I hate her.
Who are you?
In the film, Sybil harbors personalities of varying ages and characteristics, some of which are boys. The most prominent ones, however, are Peggy, a hysterical 9-year-old girl who throws temper tantrums out of fear and anger. Vicky, a sophisticated French-speaking 12-year-old girl who is aware of all the other personalities and their behaviors.
I don't even like to hurt someone's feelings. Do you know? If someone calls me Sybil by mistake, do you know what I do? I look in their face and I say, yes, yes, or we, you're speaking to me. Because it hurts to be embarrassed.
Vanessa, a young girl who falls in love with Sybil's neighbor Richard.
It hurts. When Richard kisses Sybil, it hurts. Why is that? Why does love hurt?
Marcia, an older girl infatuated with death, wearing a scarf and dressing in black. And Ruthie, a pre-verbal infant that Sybil dissociates into out of stress and traumatic memories.
What the hell did that monster do to you?
What happened in the green kitchen?
There is usually one core alternate personality, which would likely be Vicky due to her awareness of Sybil's condition and willingness as the only personality to undergo hypnosis therapy with Dr. Wilbur. DID is also characterized by amnesia occurring as gaps in the recall of everyday events, important personal information, and trauma. Sybil reports her lapses in memory to Dr. Wilbur, claiming she woke up in the water while working as a substitute teacher and at one point woke up 2 years older. Sybil is unaware of the other personalities but knows she is unwell.
I've always been like this. Always. And I used to think that everybody was like this. That they would just naturally wake up and be someplace else or a whole lot older or wearing another dress. Once I woke up, and I was 2 years older.
In order to be diagnosed with DID, the patient must be distressed by the disorder and impair daily functioning. Sybil is obviously inhibited by her disorder. She wants to be an art teacher, but because of her dissociations, she can only substitute classes for a day at a time. Furthermore, she cannot control her dissociations, which occur at lunch with her father and cause her to break glasses in windows unintentionally. Sybil's symptoms also do not occur as a result of normal cultural or religious practices, nor due to the influence of a substance. Aside from the DSM-5, there are other signs of DID that Sybil portrays in the film. She experiences auditory hallucinations triggered by a ticking alarm clock, has specific phobias of hands, dish towels, disinfectant, and the colors green and purple, and has experienced severe trauma as she was physically, verbally, emotionally, and sexually abused by her mother as a child. The film is based on a novel written by journalist Flora Retta Schreiber in 1973 in tandem with psychiatrist Dr. Cornelia Wilbur regarding the real Sybil, one of Wilbur's patients named Shirley Ardell Mason. Onlookers observed the abusive behavior of Shirley's mother, Hattie, who was allegedly schizophrenic herself, such as her vise-lock grip on her daughter's hand, and accounts from Shirley's pediatrician detailing scarring in private areas. As an adult, Shirley Mason was described as quiet but friendly, a lover of art who displayed her work in her Lexington home and worked as an assistant art professor at the University of Kentucky. The film displays Mason's hobbies through Sybil's love of painting and ability to sing, dance, and play the piano through her alternate personalities. There was no speculation of Shirley Mason's condition till friends and neighbors began to notice Dr. Wilbur's frequent visits to her home. Speculation increased by the novel's release, and it was revealed that Shirley Mason was the Sybil of the novel of the same name. lead actress Sally Fields won the Emmy Award for Outstanding Lead Actress in a Drama or Comedy Special in 1977 for her portrayal of Sybil. Because her mannerisms line up easily with the DSM-5 diagnostic criteria, the portrayal of dissociative identity disorder is highly accurate for the film in its time. In fact, the number of people who reported DID cases skyrocketed after its release and helped normalize and generate a heightened awareness for mental illness.